And I want to welcome you to our first live performance in 2 years. How about a hand for Normal Life? We have two special guests that we want to recognize right now. Many of you know we are an ag stream elementary school with an agriculture focus. And this past summer, we were able to install our first phase, which is our nature trail. It's the Sonora Owls Trail. And that would not be possible without NOLIN Operation Roundup. And to represent NOLIN, we have Miss Barbara Prophet. If you'd like to stand so we can clap for NOLIN being such a generous donor. Thank you so much. We also would like to recognize Adam Copeland, if he is here. Adam, will you stand up and wave if you are here? Give the whole Copeland family a big hand. Adam dug out the trail, spread the gravel, spent a large amount of time this summer making that happen, and we are so appreciative. We also need to thank Rocket Trucking and Vulcan Materials. They donated their time and the labor, and we so appreciate it. Now we have some special guests to thank also for tonight. Mrs. Larbeth Hayes, our vice principal, this has been a labor of love. She and her father, Brother Tim Dennis, have written this play, produced this play, and worked really hard to make it happen. So be sure and give them both a thanks. Our sound engineer, Adam Fuller, is volunteering his time. Thank you, Mr. Fuller. Also on the horizon for our Extreme program is going to be a pavilion that's going to be built right over there to the left of the shed. It's going to be an outdoor pavilion that the community can use for different events. That is courtesy of Hardin County Farm Bureau, EC3, and Lincoln Trail Homebuilders Association. Our newest partner is also Roundstone Native Seed. They're going to help us make a wildflower pollination area in the middle of the trail. So we've got a lot of big things on the way, thanks to you and to our always partners, Jones Home Center, Jordan's Greenhouse, and Sonora Feed and Supply. Thank you so much. And thank you to our custodians, our staff, and the parents who've made tonight happen. Big round of applause for everybody. Thank you so much. In just a few minutes, we will call your children to go to their classrooms to get ready to perform, but we want to give everybody a chance to make their way in. So it'll be just another few minutes, and we'll let you get some food, bid on silent auction items, and just visit with each other. Thank you.
All right, thank you so much for being out here. My name is Laura Beth Hayes. I'm the assistant principal here at Creekside. And as Ms. Custis said earlier, my dad, Tim Dennis, and I have been directing this play with the students. So we want to have a quick disclaimer before we start. As you listen to the first part of this play, please know we do not hate farmers. We are here to celebrate farmers. So if you hear things like, they're stinky farmers, or things that might offend you, please know there's more coming, and we do appreciate you. So I don't want a mass exodus of all of our farmers in the middle of this play. No, in all sincerity, we're very, very thankful to be here tonight and to have this opportunity to be out and to gather and for you to get to celebrate your children. The students that are standing over here have been working for a couple of months now, learning lines and learning to take on roles, and they have a really powerful story to share with you tonight about the value of agriculture and farming in our community and our daily lives. And of course, the other younger children are going to be coming out to sing, and they're precious as well. So I would just ask at this time if everybody could find a seat. And I would also ask that if at all possible, you would remain seated throughout the play unless there is an emergency, because it just kind of helps with the children being able to focus and keeps any kind of distractions or situations from happening. At the end of the play, we will be bringing out the grade levels that are in the building right now, and we will announce those locations at the end so that an adult in each family can go retrieve their child. But we do not want you going back in the building to get the children so it just doesn't become chaotic and we can keep everyone safe. All right, so again, thank you for being out here tonight. Thank you for being a great audience for these children and letting them shine with the hard work they've put forth. So at this time, I will let the play begin.
We, the students of Creekside Elementary, are here to tell you the ups and downs about farming. Without farmers, we would all starve to death. Without farmers, there would be no McDonald's, no Chick-fil-A, no Dairy Queen, no restaurants or grocery stores.
That sounds serious.
Yes, it is, but thankfully we have farmers, men, women, teenagers, and even children that work hard to provide for our food.
I work hard eating my food.
Now, Most of us have learned about farming since we were little kids singing songs. The most favorite has been Old MacDonald Had a Farm.
Old MacDonald's has a farm? Is that where they grow the Happy Meals?
McDonald's is not on a farm, and nobody raises Happy Meals on a farm. But they need farmers like Old MacDonald to provide all the products for those Happy Meals.
Well, you tell Old MacDonald that we're thankful for all the work he does. I like to eat. But if there's not enough to go around, I will gladly give someone my piece.
Did you know that some of the most famous people in our nation's history knew the importance of farmers?
Dwight D. Eisenhower. Farming looks mighty easy when your plow is a pencil and you're 1,000 miles from the cornfield.
Booker T. Washington. No race can prosper until it learns as much dignity as in tilling a field as in writing a poem.
Thomas Jefferson. Agriculture is our wisest pursuit because it will, in the end, contribute to the most real wealth, good morals, and happiness.
George Washington. I would rather be on my farm than be an emperor of the world.
Farming is a profession of hope.
Farmers can take their kids to work any day they want.
Showing kids how food goes from farm to table is an important first step in creating a healthy eating habit.
It isn't the farm that makes a farm, but it's the love, hard work, and character.
Can we sing now?
Sing? What song?
A farming song.
Which one?
Old MacDonald. Old MacDonald's had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on his farm there were some french fries, E-I-E-I-O. With a munch munch here and a munch munch there. You're much there, much everywhere, much, much. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O.
You have a lot to learn about farming. The Creekside Elementary Drama Group presents A Farmer's Tale.
We are out here to make something beautiful for all the students to enjoy. Part of growing up is learning to make a contribution.
The only thing I'm making is blisters on my hands, and I have a broken nail.
Miss D told us to wear gloves.
Those things look dirty, and do they ever smell?
Mrs. D, my gloves are too big. Can I have an extra pair?
Well, they're gloves my family uses on the farm.
And besides, they scratch my fingers.
Scratchy fingers versus blisters! Only Sarah!
Don't blisters help develop calluses?
You don't understand! Most girls don't want calluses or blisters or scratchy fingers! When is our break time? Are we gonna have to slave all day?
Sam, we aren't slaves. We are artists, and our canvas is the soil.
Great. It's hot, I'm sweaty, I'm hungry, and I'm thirsty. And have to listen to a fifth grade philosopher. Mary, did you know most philosophers did not work in the soil?
And most artists work with paint, not dirt.
Mary, I like what you said. A poet once said we have neglected the truth that a good farmer is a craftsman of the highest order, a kind of artist.
I never want to be a farmer. I want to be a nurse.
While nursing is a noble career, sometimes nurses might need a hobby like gardening to help with the stress. I have a surprise for you, but it'll be a while before it arrives. So in the meantime, please just work and stop the complaining.
Why do we have to do this? I never want to work in a garden. Too many wiggly things. I want to be a fashion designer. If I'm going to get blisters on my hands, it's going to be from cutting out fabric, making clothes.
I want to be a professional basketball player. Farmers are dirty. Most of them stink.
And how many farmers have you smelled, Avery?
A few.
in the Dollar General store.
Avery, how did you know they were farmers? Did they have name tags that said, "Hello, I'm a stinky farmer"? Besides, most basketball players stink too, after a practice or game.
Yeah, don't even get me started about my brother. He smells after he plays basketball, but then he smells before that too. Ew!
Not me. I always radiate the sweet smell of victory.
You gotta quit playing against those first graders, Avery.
Now listen, agriculture's a critical part of our lives.
Yeah, without farmers, our roads will be free from all the dirt from their tractors. Farmers, who needs them?
Have you ever gotten by a farm and took a big whiff of the air? Smelly! It is true that bugs will pass by farmers because they stink so bad. There should be a law against stink pollution.
And they are so slow when they are on the roads. I get so mad when I get behind a tractor and wagon and cannot get to Deucer's for ice cream.
Boy, do you kids have a lot to learn. Oh, hi, Jane. I know you come from a family of farmers. I think these kids need a little help on the proper use of garden tools.
It's the farmer girl.
Belle, do you want to help or do you want to criticize? In fact, I have lots of math papers for anyone who wants to sit inside.
I want to help, but who really wants to be a farmer? All they do is plant corn, plant beans, and then raise cows this year, and then plant corn, plant beans, and then raise cows the next. Boring!
Josie, some farmers enjoy being one with nature and watch the creation of life with little pigs, chicks, and calves. There is something beautiful about what they do, although I don't want to be a farmer either.
Beautiful? I'm with Josie. Boring!
Okay, Jane is going to show how garden tools work the best, so it won't be so hard for you.
Okay, Mrs. D. Attention, in case you did not know, this is a rake.
Get lost, Farmer Jane!
Don't you have some little piggies to take to the market?
That's funny, Belle.
Actually, the piggies are too little right now, but in a few months, they'll be taken to the market, and they won't be going wee, wee, wee all the way home.
I could never kill an animal.
Oh, really? Or I guess you just eat them. Or have you never been to Chick-fil-A?
Okay, but I'm a vegan. I don't plan to eat any animals. We should let them live.
That is nice. But do you know how many animals are killed when grain farmers harvest their crops that vegans eat? Thousands. It is unintentional, but it happens. It sounds like all of you need to learn more about agriculture.
Agriculture? Who cares? My mom and dad get our food from Kroger, and we're not farmers.
Not to take Jane's side, but Sam, where do you think all that food comes from that they have at Kroger?
I don't know. Trucks, warehouses, Amazon.
I heard my grandma say many times, occasionally you'll need a lawyer, a doctor, a policeman, and a preacher. But every day, three times a day, you need a farmer.
I still just don't get it. Why would anybody want to be a farmer?
Well, it may be hard to understand, but every spring, me and my parents get this bug for farming.
Ugh! Is it like the coronavirus? Where's my mask? Stay away!
We don't have to wear them outside, do we, Jane?
It is not that type of bug. It is more of an itch.
Mrs. D, where do we keep the first aid kit? Surely there's some cortisone cream there if she has an itch.
Tina, what I'm trying to tell you is that there is something inside of us that wants to watch things grow.
I saw this Star Trek movie where this bug crawled in this guy's ear. Is that what happened to you?
Mrs. D, I'm not having much success here. They just don't get that farmers are the grassroots of society, and without farmers, nothing happens.
Right. Daniel Webster said, when farming begins, other arts follow. The farmers, therefore, are the grassroots of human civilization. I see the van coming. It's time for a break.
Can I run to the restroom? I won't soak my hands.
No! I have a basin, soap, water, and wipes. We don't have time to go in to just wash our hands.
What? I have dirt under my fingernails.
Okay, but the rest of us are going to enjoy pizza. Yay!
I love pizza.
Me too. Hot, cheesy pizza.
Tina, you go to the restroom, but don't be surprised if you run out of pizza. I'm so hungry I could eat a horse.
Really? Vegan!
It's just an expression. I don't really want to eat a horse when there's pepperoni pizza lying around.
Not to hurt your feelings, but pepperonis come from...
I don't want to hear it. Those are plant-based pepperonis.
What? Vegetable pepperonis?
I don't care. Nobody gets my share of the pizza.
Here's your pizza, hot and fresh from Pizza Hut.
Did you bring any garlic butter?
I brought you cheese you ordered. I'm just a delivery person.
Thank you. I'm sure everything is fine.
Before you eat, I want to ask you to thank a farmer.
Thank a farmer? This pizza came from Pizza Hut, not from old McDonald and his farm.
Scissors D, they have got a lot to learn, don't they? While you guys stuff your faces with pizza, I'm going to get some of my family and farmer friends to come by and help you guys learn more about agriculture.
You do that, Jane. Can I please eat your pizza while you go get them?
I hope you're kidding. We all need to share what we have. While we're eating pizza, the Creekside kindergartners would like to share a few songs for us about animals down on the farm.
Learn to make animal sounds with us. Look, it's a pig.
Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on that farm he had a pig, E-I-E-I-O. With an oink oink here and an oink oink there, here an oink, there an oink, everywhere an oink oink. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O.
The duck is in the pond.
Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on the farm he had a duck, E-I-E-I-O. With a quack quack here and a quack quack there, here a quack, there a quack, everywhere a quack quack. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O.
Can you see the horse?
Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on the farm he had a horse, E-I-E-I-O. With a neigh neigh here and a neigh neigh there, here a neigh, there a neigh, everywhere a neigh neigh. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O.
Can you hear the sheep?
With a baa baa here and a baa baa there, here a baa, there a baa, everywhere a baa baa. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O.
The cows in the meadow.
Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on that farm he had a cow, E-I-E-I-O. With a moo moo here and a moo moo.
Ducks came back. One, two.
2, 3. Three little ducks went out one day, over the hill and far away. Mother duck said quack, 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 but only 2 little ducks came back. 1, 2. Little ducks went out one day, over the hill and far away. Mother duck said quack, 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 but only 1 little duck came back. 1. 1 little duck went out one day, over the hill and far away. Mother duck said quack, 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 but none of the 5 little ducks came back. Sad mother duck went out one day, over the hill and far away. Mother duck said quack, 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 and all of the 5 little ducks came back. 5 little ducks went out one day, over the hill and far away. Mother duck said quack, 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 and all of the 5 little ducks came back.
Thank you, Creekside kindergartners. Hey, look who's here.
This is my friend Sally. Her family owns a farm down the road.
Hey everybody, Jane asked me to come by and talk to you about farming. You can listen while you eat.
Oh, we will listen, won't we? Hey Farmer Sally, what do you do down on the farm?
I help with animals, pigs mainly.
Is your last name McDonald and your pigs go oink oink here and oink oink there?
That's funny, Mary. What would a pig farmer have to tell us? After all, how many brains does it take to say, Suey, Suey, and toss them some food?
It doesn't take many brains to make fun of people either.
Belle, have you heard of the common diseases among pigs like cholera and foot and mouth disease?
Hey, Belle has that foot and mouth disease. I hear it's incurable for boys.
What I am talking about can kill pigs, and certain steps must be taken to keep pigs from dying. But then I'm not smart enough to know about that since I'm only a stinky farmer. I still don't get why we have to have farmers. Have you ever put on makeup like your mother?
Well, she only lets me every once in a while.
Did you know that the base ingredient in some makeup comes from pig collagen? So no pigs, no makeup.
Pigs go to college?
Collagen, it is made from the skin and bones of pigs.
And girls put that on their faces? That's disgusting!
Well, I don't use makeup.
Well, Josie, no offense, but maybe you should. Sorry, no offense. Wow, something blowing in the wind. Mary, why don't you go run after it so we won't have to deal with your nonsense?
They use collagen for other things, too.
Really? Like what?
You like Jell-O?
What does Jell-O have to do with pigs?
Collagen is an ingredient in lots of Jell-O and gelatin products.
So, Jell-O is made from pigs? Ew!
I will never eat Jell-O again.
I just don't know why anyone would want to spend their lives around messy, stinky pigs.
Well, for one thing, if there were no farmers working with stinky pigs, there would be no pepperonis.
My mommy buys pepperonis from Kroger, not from old McDonald and his farm.
We get our pepperoni pizzas at the Dollar General. Tombstone pizzas, they are good and quick to fix.
I hate to break it to you, but pepperonis come from pigs long before your mommy finds them in Kroger. So it makes sense to me, if you don't like farmers, I will just have to keep these pepperonis for myself. My dog would love them.
Hey, those are our pepperonis. You just can't take them away.
Every vegan knows that pepperonis, bacon, sausage, tenderloin, and ham all come from pigs. So if you don't mind, I would like to come to all of y'all's homes and collect things pigs like mine give to us.
I think Sally has made her point. I hope all of you like cheese pizza.
Thank you, Sally. I'm sure we've learned a lot about pigs. The Creekside first graders are going to share a few songs for us about animals down on the farm.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Chickens out of the chicken pen. Chicken one and chicken two.
Chicken one and chicken two.
Let's all do the chicken chew.
Let's all do the chicken chew.
Bop, 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 bop,
bop, bop, bop, bop, bop, bop, bop, bop.
Chicken two and chicken three.
Chicken two and chicken three.
Let's all climb the chicken tree.
Let's all climb the chicken tree.
Bop, 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 bop,
bop, bop, bop.
A farmer had a dog. head.
There was a farmer, had a dog, and Bingo was his name-o.
Creekside kindergartners. Hey, look who's here. There are all types of animals on a farm. Dogs, cats, horses, chickens, cows, mules, and pigs.
That's okay with me. I only like cheese pizza. You can keep the pepperonis.
Don't take mine. I like pepperonis and I'm not a vegan. Can I have hers?
I have more friends coming.
Sam, cheese comes from... Oh, hi, Violet. Jane was just about to tell us where cheese comes from. I know you were going to dairy, so I'll let you explain.
Sure. Cheese comes from the milk that we get from our cows.
The milk in my refrigerator comes from Dean's. It says so right on the jug. What do cows have to do with anything?
Really?
Violet, Tina's been painting her fingernails too much. Even I know that milk and cheese come from cows.
Then you know that modern farmers must milk those cows twice a day, usually with very expensive and sophisticated equipment. Some are even computer-driven. That takes a lot of commitment and skill to have milk in your refrigerator and cheese on your pizza.
Really? I thought all you had to do was put your cows out in your pasture, let them eat, and then milk them by hand. That's the way I've seen it on television. That really doesn't take too many brains.
Grass or hay is just one part of their diet. For them to stay healthy, it takes a lot of knowledge. Cows need lots of nutrients, minerals, and salts.
Telling me you have to be smart to be a farmer?
Smarter than it takes to ask that question, Billy.
Billy, do you like onions with ice cream?
Onions on hamburgers, but not ice cream.
Well, what if I told you that if a farmer lets a cow eat wild onions, it'll affect the taste of milk? Do you want onion-flavored ice cream?
This is just too confusing. You make it sound like if we didn't have farmers, then we wouldn't have milk or cheese.
I think she's beginning to see the light.
That's exactly what I'm saying. No farmers, no cheese, no milk, and no cheese pizzas.
Hey, isn't it sort of like the book, The Christmas Carol, where Scrooge is visited by all those ghosts? I'm beginning to think there's a pattern here. It seems like we're being visited by the ghost farming, only they are not dead. I get one slice of pizza with pepperonis and cheese, but now I have this crust and tomato sauce. Oh well, I like breadsticks dipped in sauce.
It reminds me of planting. The Creekside second graders are going to sing a song for us about planting.
There is a little red hen. Down on Grandpa's farm, there is a little red hen. The hen, it makes a sound like this. The hen, it makes a sound like this. We're on our way, on our way to Grandpa's farm. We're on our way, on our way to Grandpa's farm. Down on Grandpa's farm, there is a big brown cow. Down on Grandpa's farm, there is
a big brown cow. The cow, it makes a sound like this. The cow, it makes a sound like this.
Creekside second graders. Thank you, Creekside second graders. Having grown up on a farm, I enjoyed all the references of hard work a farmer does down on the farm.
Hold on there.
Oh, hi, Polly. Glad you could come by.
you're dirty.
Just came from the farm. I grow tomatoes, potatoes, beans, corn, and lots of other vegetables. I have what is called cash crops. I grow lots of food that people want.
Ugh, working in the dirt with bugs and wiggly things? That's just disgusting.
Bella, did you know that those worms aerate the soil for things to grow better?
Really? I thought they were worms so I could go fishing.
Who would want to eat a fish that eats worms?
Maybe the same person that eats chicken that eats bugs?
Farmers provide all kinds of fruits and vegetables that we eat.
I don't like vegetables. Give me fruit from the golden arches and I'll be happy.
So you like french fries?
Well, duh, who doesn't?
Sarah, french fries comes from potatoes, which are vegetables?
What? No one ever told me I'm eating vegetables.
Maybe not the healthiest way to eat vegetables, but potatoes are vegetables, and all those potatoes come from...
I know, from Idaho. I really like the sack of potatoes at my house.
Well, for farmers in Idaho, if it wasn't for farmers or gardeners, we wouldn't have green beans, baked beans, corn on the cob, peanuts, or broccoli and cauliflower.
Broccoli and cauliflower? Now I know I don't like farmers. They're the ones responsible for my mother making me eat that stuff. No farmers, no cauliflower. Sounds good to me.
Yeah, without tomatoes, cucumbers, or pickles. Tina, I'm beginning to think we need those farmers.
Well, I don't like tomatoes either. They're too juicy. Pizza, yes. Farmers, no.
Ooh, if you're gonna trash farmers, then I guess I'll have to scrape off some of this tomato sauce. You wouldn't want food grown from some silly farmer. Maybe it's poisonous or not so suitable for people to eat. And of course, tomato sauce comes from tomatoes.
Pizza without pepperonis, cheese, tomato sauce? That's un-American!
You mean we're just reduced to bread and water?
Mary, that is not water. Those are cans of some Mountain Dew and Pepsi.
Don't tell me Pepsis come from farmers.
I'm not going to take away your Pepsis, although I thought we weren't allowed to have soft drinks in school.
Jane, Mrs. D said it's a special occasion. Don't you listen?
Mrs. D, didn't you tell me that George Washington was a farmer?
Yes, I did. George Washington once said, when farming begins, other arts follow. Farming is the most useful, most noble, and most healthful employment of man.
Somehow, my enthusiasm for pizza has dried up. Who ever heard of pizza with no cheese, tomato sauce, or pepperonis? Our surprise has turned into a surprise. Just crust.
Belle, be thankful for what you have. Bread is awesome. People have to eat all day.
Little Miss Philosopher at it again.
Well, look at it this way. If we just eat bread, then we are bound to lose some weight.
And who among us needs to lose weight, Sarah?
Here comes Peaches.
Who in their right mind would name their kid Peaches?
Well, Peaches is my nickname. My real name is Penelope. It was my mother's idea. I like Peaches the best. So does my dad. He's a fruit farmer, orchard, strawberries, pumpkins, and grapes. He likes Peaches the best, so he calls me Peaches.
Would he have called you Winesap if he liked apples the best?
Okay, Peaches is here to tell us about another part of farming. I have to go check on something. Listen to Peaches!
At least you can't take away our crust. Don't tell me that pizza crust comes from fruits.
Well, no. Crust comes from grain, mostly. The grain farmer's coming next. Have any of you gone to Mr. Gaddy's?
Not enough. It's my favorite pizza place. I can get all I want.
Then have you had the pizzas with pineapples, strawberries, and cherries on them?
Yes, I love apple and cinnamon pizza.
I like pineapple on my pizza.
Don't tell me it takes brains to put a tree in the ground and let it grow.
Ever been to an orchard?
Well, no, but I have gone to the fruit section at Walmart. You just go there and get apples, oranges, peaches, and watermelons. It's pretty easy.
Ever heard of peach tree curls? What do you do to stop them? Ever pruned a tree?
What's pruning?
It is cutting off certain branches so the others can be more productive. Of course, you have to know which branch to cut off, and that takes a lot of brains.
That sounds worse than boys. This is just too confusing.
I've been to an orchard, and I just like going to a tree and picking apples off a tree. It's fun.
I'm glad you like it. Just remember that farmers like my parents have to know a lot and do a lot before apples ever appear. Big, bright, red, juicy apples just don't grow without lots of help.
Didn't Johnny Appleseed plant all the apple trees?
Sam, you did not just say that.
Now I know where nut trees come from.
Well, I learned it in school.
My teacher read this from a book. I think I didn't pay attention.
It was a story. Not every apple tree got its in the USA got its start from Johnny Appleseed.
Oh, well, I have some dessert pizzas for you, but I hear you don't like farmers like my dad. So I guess I'll just have to hand these out to the audience. I bet some fourth and fifth graders will love these pizzas.
Hey, those are our pizzas.
Yes, they are, but if I give them to you, then I'll have to take the fruit away. Farmers plant the strawberry seedlings and all the other types of fruit. So without farmers, no apples and no apple cinnamon pizza.
The sun shines bright to give it life, and it will grow till fall. Grow, grow, grow a garden, grow it nice and green. The rain will help our garden grow to the biggest you've ever seen. The plant in the ground will get the food that's found from the dirt, yes, the dirt that's spread all around. And plants drink water too, they are just like you. And when the rain comes pouring down, that's just what they do. Grow, grow, grow a garden, grow it nice and tall. The sun shines bright to give it life, and it will grow till fall. Grow, grow, grow a garden, grow it nice and green. The rain will help our garden grow to the biggest you've ever seen. And out comes the sun to dry up all the rain, the plants their energy to help them through the day. Yes, day after day, the garden finds a way to grow itself big and strong, a beautiful bouquet. Grow, grow, grow a garden, grow it nice and tall. The sun shines bright to give it life, and it will grow till fall. Grow, grow, grow a garden, grow it nice and green. The rain will help our garden grow to the biggest you've ever seen. Vegetables and fruit that we pluck from their vines that you can chop and chew. Absolutely fresh, tasty and delicious. Healthy treats we like to eat and totally nutritious. Grow, grow, grow a garden, grow it nice and tall. The sun shines bright to give it life, and it will grow till fall. Grow, grow, grow a garden, grow it nice and green. The rain will help our garden grow to the biggest you've ever seen.
Above and the ocean below. Now I may be a little bigger than you, but as you grow, you'll get bigger too. Think about a great big tree. It started out as a tiny little seed. It needed the sun to help it grow. Now little seeds, not little anymore.
this pear, that frog, my hair. These are all things that grow. And hey, it's true, you're growing too. These are all things that grow. Think about a butterfly. It used to be a little caterpillar guy. Spent 7 days in a little cocoon. Now we can watch him fly around the room. That corn, my beard, these are all things that grow. And hey, it's true, you're growing too. These are all things that grow. Think of all the things that grow in the sky above and the ocean below. Now I may be a little bigger than you, but as you grow, you'll get bigger too. Your tongue, this beet, that duck, my feet, these are all things that grow. Just wait and see, you'll grow like me. These are all things that grow. Think of all the things that grow.
Feel like we're on a losing team that's 50 points behind and 5 minutes left in the game, and even Avery can't help us win?
Not me. I'm hungry, and if crust is all I get, then I just have to eat the crust. Was there any garlic butter in those boxes?
Some people never know when they're losing. Jane, your friends are convincing, but why can't farmers just move to Texas, do their farming there, then we wouldn't have to put up with all the problems farmers create?
Some people might think the same things about factories and other businesses too, but farmers have the right to live and work wherever they live too. Here comes Felix.
Did I hear you talk about the problems that farmers create? Have you ever gotten Coke cans out of a combine because some litter bug threw them in our fields? And I cannot begin to tell you how many McDonald's bags end up getting wedged in our equipment. And the speeders, they race up and down the road, run through our fences, never call to tell us, and then our cows get out on the road. Somebody could get killed, let alone our cows. Don't tell me about problems.
Woo, who are you?
Felix is my name, and my family are grain farmers. Wheat, soybeans, and corn.
Who ever heard of a farmer named Felix?
My mama grew up watching Felix the Cat cartoons. Her daddy likes them.
So your mama named you Felix? I am so sorry.
And your name is Sam, which is a boy's name?
It's short for Samantha, my mama, like Bewitched.
Okay, let's hear it. We've been through this with all the other farmers. Why are grain farmers important?
Well, for one thing, we grew some of the ingredients in that piece of pizza crust you are eating. And who in the right mind would order just pizza crust? It doesn't look good.
Felix, it's been a long story. Let's just say we're eating the product of our snickering about farmers.
All these farmer people came to steal our beds and ingredients!
Farmers stealing?
Well, not exactly. We were making fun of farmers, so they took the ingredients away from us to help us understand how important farming was, I guess.
Well, in that case, let me give you something else to snicker about. If there's no farmers, no grain, so no wheat, which means no pizza crust, it has to go. Understand the problem. You don't want farmers, so obviously you don't want what they produce. Do any of you like Sugar Pops, Cheerios, or Sugar Crisp? Sugar Pops come from corn, Cheerios from oats, and Sugar Crisp from wheat. All three come from farms.
I think we've made a terrible mistake. It's missing farmers and agriculture.
Well, it's back to work. How are the snacks?
The snacks! Oh, you mean the pizza that was taken away from us bit by bit?
Well, we've reaped what we sow. Oh, that's a farming joke.
Drop it, Mary.
Save your jokes and philosophy for someone who cares. It's not fair. We didn't get to enjoy our delicious pizza after working so dang hard.
Life doesn't always seem fair, but remember, you weren't being fair to farmers. Onions would be very scarce if it weren't for the hard work farmers do to provide for the fruit that goes on our plates. So have you learned anything today?
I learned to keep my mouth shut and not make fun of farming.
Well, I've learned that we all need each other, no matter what career we choose. If I'm a farmer, people need me every day when there's... if I'm a nurse, people will need me every day when they're sick, but people need farmers every day.
Okay. I was wrong. We were all wrong.
But please, Mrs. D, can we have just one slice of pizza with cheese, tomato sauce, pepperonis, and the crust?
Fantastic. Audience, would you please give these very talented boys and girls one more round of applause, please? They did an exceptional job. Also, if you're in the audience and you are a farmer, would you please stand? If we have any farmer families in the audience, would you please stand? I know we do, so stand up, please. Let's give them a round of applause, please. And thank you for not being offended by the comments in the play. Now, thank you very much again for coming out tonight and being a part of this. It was so great to have such a great crowd and to see the students perform as well as they did. We're very proud of them.